Double extension, double retraction. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode on the Single Player World. How you doing? I hope you're doing well. I'm doing really good. We're over here at the flower farm area. And guys, I overcomplicated this again, obviously, like I always do. I always overcomplicate things. So I'm going to show you what I did to fix it, what I did to, to come up with a new design for some new ones. I think they work pretty well. So check this out. So if you didn't see it in one of the last episodes, we built this little flower deal over here. And it works pretty well. It had a minecart collection thing, and I took that out. I also took out all the other redstone over here because I realized that was totally unnecessary. It wasn't helping us out any. So now it's just manual. You can just stand here. You can watch everything happen. Come on, there we go, starting to do stuff. And then when you're done, you can just collect it manually, obviously, like I was saying. It's so much easier than doing the minecart. I don't know what I was thinking. That is a lot easier. Obviously, my inventory is totally full because I've got all of the stuff to build a couple more flower farms, which is what you see right here. So this is my new iteration of that, but a lot better because these are totally AFKable and they'll fill a chest up like completely perfectly. Which is awesome, which means you don't have to sit around, wait for it, collect it, all that stuff. So let me show you what's going on here. It's pretty simple. We got a bone meal chest, and we've got a little flower spawning area. And once again, we got lights here. So if you turn it off and it's flooded in that process, then the water won't kill the grass down there. So you can turn it on and it'll work instantly. So let's do that. So what I did is I chose two areas because I can't remember which one is which. But one of these has the azure mulets, the white guys, those ones. And I think that's this one. Yep, there we go. Although it is somewhat infrequent, it does generate those guys. There you go. Along with a couple of these red tulips. So, you can see we got a bunch of these azure boulettes out of this one. Alright, so that's that one. In case we need the light gray dye. Then I got one over here because we needed these magenta colored ones. These are really good for the end project because we use magenta colored glass and stuff over there. So this is the same deal, except on this one, the purple ones spawn. So this is really cool. This is like a really good way. If you need like one type, you know, you just pick a type where that is and you build one of these guys. And then bam, you've got an AFK way to get dye. Now it's not super fast like that. That's why that one's there is because it does have a bunch of different colors and it's really, really quick. So if you just want a whole bunch right now, then that's the one to use. But if you need a specific color, then yeah, these are the ones to go with. And so I think what I'm going to do, let's look at this. What other flowers around here do I need? Okay, this one I think is actually going to be kind of cool. The way that I designed it, like so. I really like it so far. Just, I know it's nothing yet, but you know what I'm saying. Like, I like how it's laid out. I think it's going to work well. So you can see, put in the floor. And we're going to choose a side where our collection is going to be on, because on the opposite side is where your hopper, or not your hopper, your dispenser is going to be on, with your bucket of water. So you want to make sure that those are diagonal from each other, or else it's not going to work. And let's give this guy a bucket. Give it a bucket. Okay. So the redstone here is super, super, super simple. It's literally all it is a hopper clock, which we haven't put in yet. That's going to activate that dispenser. And then that dispenser every time it goes back and forth. It's super simple. So let's try and find a spot for that. I'm kind of thinking, let's see, let's put it on this side because that's where both of our dispensers are on, or the side that they're both on. So let's just dig out a big area for it. Yeah, and slap it down there. And then that's basically it. It's pretty cool. And then obviously the lever is just going to be able to snake its way over to the timer and turn it off. Cool. So we got our hopper timer in. I think this is going to be pretty simple and kind of cool. I'm not sure if it's going to work yet. Oh, I almost broke everything. I'm really glad I remembered to put this here. We got a wall off our little area so it doesn't flood. Like that. And then this one over here needs a piece of glass over it. So we can open the chest. Obviously, you don't have to put the chest right there. That's just how I've been building these. Let's give it a little bit more light. Oh yeah, and we gotta have some sea lanterns in here to keep the grass alive, so we might as well put that in right now. Let's just do that. Ba-ba-bum. Cool. Well, yeah, that's a pretty simple little flower farm. I'm pretty happy with that. Like I said, I'll say it again. I'm not sure if somebody else has already come up with this design, but like, you know, like I was talking about, it's one of those things that probably everybody builds flower farm, who builds Flower Farm. Probably everybody has come up with something similar to this at one point. So yeah, anyway, let's patch this up and let's turn it on and let's see if we did what we're supposed to do. You know what, sheep, you're in the way. Okay, well, I'm gonna do a little bit of this redstone. I'm gonna hook up this lever over to here somehow. And then, oh, by the way, we could probably throw some items in here. I'm gonna wait till I do the lever, just cause obviously I know it's gonna work. I've already built a couple of these. So I'll just figure something out while I talk about something else. So, inventory, right? This freaking inventory, this is the biggest problem in the game. The biggest problem in Minecraft in general, not console edition, just in Minecraft, is inventory management. It's really difficult. It's most of the gameplay is just flicking through chests and inventory and sorting stuff. So, what am I trying to say? So in the new Shulker box update thing that dropped on PC quite a while ago, now you're able to store a lot more in your inventory. It's just making me realize that I really, really, really want dual wielding and shulker boxes. I just think those two things are like so essential, and I don't know why they're waiting so long to add it. Maybe it's a technical limitation, who knows. But my point is that I realized something about, you know, I mentioned that I might have to reset the end, and that would suck because we got all these iron farms and stuff, and I'm not going to do that. Well, I realized that if they ever do drop that update, guys, I've only opened one end portal in the end, like end city portal. So we'll just be able to open up another one of the freaking portals by fighting the dragon, and then bam, we'll have a bunch of shulker boxes. So I'm not too worried about it. The thing I am worried about is that I really hope, really hope, I'm kind of stalling here on the redstone while I'm talking about this, but I really freaking hope that you don't just get a shulker, like one shell per shulker. You know what I'm saying? Because there are not enough shulkers in console edition. So if they do that, they're basically screwing us. You know what I'm saying? They're just screwing us. So I really, really can't stress enough that I really think that they should add it to be, you get a whole box worth of shells from each shulker. Either that, or there's a way to like reset the end cities to get more. There's just, it's just gonna be so frustrating when we finally do get that update and then people can only get like 15 of them per world. You know what I mean? Because there just aren't enough shulkers, because there aren't enough gateways, because there's not enough cities, because it's not infinite. Anyway, my gosh, that was a little bit of a rant. Let's turn this on. Oh, duh, we gotta put items in it. So is this locking it? I'm pretty sure that this is like locking it in a certain state. No, it's not going to lock it in a certain state, obviously. Maybe if we took this out. Oh, but then it's not going to connect to the piston. So I'm okay. Hold on a second. While talking and like not realizing what the heck I'm doing. Professional redstone. Let's put a block there and a torch. There we go. This is going to lock that hopper clock. So it won't activate unless we want it to activate. Get the heck out of the hole and turn on the freaking thing. Are you going to do it? You like that? Oh, wait. I keep on freaking doing this. Keep on forgetting to put items in here. I think I'm going to go with 4 items. That seems like a good amount. I think that's about how much I had in the other ones. I can't remember. Mm-hmm. You going to do stuff today? Dang it. Man, I severely messed this up today. Man, the last couple of these I built were just super simple. They fit together instantaneously. I've got an issue here, and I can't figure out what it is. There we go. So can I keep adding delay? Cool, there we go. I just screwed this up, but I think it's working now. There we go. Perfect. All right. So that was a total like cluster, but you did see all the pieces that went into there. And you can see that it is working. So again, these are pretty slow little farms, but like it's so simple, guys. That was so simple to build. I just goofed up a little bit, but it was because I was talking to you guys and building it at the same time. So if you're gonna build this yourself, man, I mean, it's gonna be super simple. Just remember you want a slight bit of delay from one to the other. Yeah, I think 4 items should do pretty much fine. I mean, look at that. Yeah, and then obviously sometimes you'll get grass only. But then hopefully if you put this in a certain spot, you'll get whatever types of flowers that you got there. And I went for white tulips. So I think that's... Oh, and pink tulips apparently too. So let's check the chest. And there you go. So I wanted both of these in one area so I could only get these because these are like my favorite flowers in the game to use decoratively. So I think I'm gonna, you know, use this one probably quite a bit. Anyway, that was pretty cool. That was our first little redstone project for the day. Let's move on here. I got another one for you, and it's in a completely different area. So let's pop over there. Let's cop over there, sure. Now, BRB. Oh, a little bit of a fourth wall for you today. I have a really bad microphone. I'm so sorry. Probably hear it from all of those different noises I just made. I kind of tried to make that a little bit more extreme than normal, so you could hear that this microphone is terrible. I bought this headset. It's a wraparound headset with a little flip down microphone deal, like you always see, when I first got my console. So it's a few years old now. And the wires are all coming apart. The part where it connects to the headphone from the wire is just like bare wire. And I keep wrapping electrical tape around it, and it keeps on, you know, moving and shrinking and everything. And so it keeps breaking and stuff. And it's just so frustrating. And the microphone sucks. So I just wanted to take a minute to say I am sorry that my audio is not up ship shape. I think that's probably my biggest issue here on my channel. And the reason is because of a number of different things, I guess, why I haven't bought a microphone. But yeah, I guess here's a little bit of the talky bit for you guys today. Obviously, there's something over here, a big mushroom farm. You probably know what's going on. I'll show you that in a minute. Just to finish my point, though. So my lifestyle that I've chosen for myself, because I think it's everyone's responsibility to choose a lifestyle that works for them. My lifestyle is very minimal. Very, very minimal lifestyle. Oh yeah, I didn't look up anything. I changed this around because I realized it'd be probably cooler to have this in the middle, and it's much more compact. So my lifestyle is very minimal. I have almost no bills. I have literally my phone bill, my housing bill, you know, and pay for electric and the rent and all that stuff that you gotta pay for just because it's like the thing. And it's food, and that's basically it. I don't really pay for car stuff. I barely ever drive. I do have a vehicle, but I don't pay for any of that stuff because I never need it. I just, like I said, I'm very minimal usage. And so what that means is that I don't really need to make very much money either because I'm not spending very much money. So I don't have a job at the moment. I'm just kind of floating about making odds and ends and doing the random stuff. I know this is not a Minecraft-centered thing, but I promise it's got a point behind it. And the point is, I said, yeah, I don't have money to buy a microphone. Like, and I don't want to buy like a $30 microphone because that would just be in the same position that we're in today. So I've got a couple lined up that I really want. I'm probably just going to go for like a Blue Yeti Snowball or something that everybody uses just because it's like popular. You know, it looks good. It doesn't matter how it looks, but you know, it sounds good. So I'm probably just going to go for something simple like that. So maybe like $50 to $100. But like I said, I don't have that kind of money. And so, yeah, if anybody's feeling like they really can't stand my microphone, then pop me a freaking check and I'll fix it instantaneously. But obviously it's going to be a couple weeks. I'm going to make some money and I'll buy a new microphone and it should be amazing because right now I've got the golden voice, but I'm talking through brass pipes, if you know what I'm saying. So anyway, that was just a little random sidetracky thing. Like I said, fourth wall, but it's over with. Let's get back to the game. So over here, Chorus Farm, you've seen it. I've been working. I think it looks nice. We've been doing the block collection stuff, and it's working out. I changed some colors in here. These things are working phenomenally. I think this is probably the best method to go with. Maybe a different design for the trapdoors, but I think it's working really well. I've also built a little bit of a storage thing in here. I don't think the Enderman can be in here with the trapdoors, which is making me realize this is a really great way to make rooms in the end. You just put trapdoors on the ceiling and they can't go in here, I think. I'm not sure. Yeah, and then we've got a little bit of an auto smelter. Super simple. I mean, you just put all the fuel in here. I'm using mushroom blocks, obviously. And it filters down into here. And then look at this. Put some signs down here. So there's only one stack in the bottom at all times. So this one will fill up quicker. You don't have to keep like five stacks of mushroom blocks in here. Pretty cool. And then a little bit of storage. Been building up some fruit and some flowers and some other stuff. Yeah, so let's talk about this. This is really cool. I really like this a lot, but it's not practical. It doesn't really work, and I'm going to rip it all out and change it to be very much more simple. So what I've got here is a mushroom. So again, like you probably know what's going on here, but we need fuel to smelt stuff. And what's just the best way The best renewable fuel source in the game, I'm pretty sure it's these mushroom blocks, because you can instant mine them. Pretty much no other fuel source in the game can you get through instant mining and as quickly as this. So yeah, like I said, I think this is the best fuel source, so I threw one of these in here. Let's clear the inventory out, and let's give this a whirl. I'll show you how it works. It's pretty simple. You probably already know how it works, but let's get this axe. This is our Ender Cleaver, which just has Silk Touch and all of the other stuff. It just happens to be amazing just because I've got a lot of books. But yeah, so let's turn on the lever, and you'll be able to see how this works. So you walk up here, and you can sneak, and you can instant mine all the blocks. And because there's a little bit of lag in the end, it's actually kind of frustrating. But if you just go a little bit slowly, you'll get everything like so, and then you rip out the ceiling. And then this is the cool part. When you take that stem out right here, we've got a little tree farm circuit that makes this double piston extender retract. Check that out. See, then you can walk around. You can pick up all your mushroom blocks. I usually do this like every four or five mushrooms, not every single time. But then when you want to grow, we got mushrooms over here. When you want to grow a new one, you slap it down. And this is where I get frustrated. So supposed to bring you back up automatically. So you're up here again. You could just hold the sneak button the whole time. You never have to move. You know what I'm saying? But I'll show you the issue here. Let's pop this out. Let's go back down. I'll show you all the redstone under here too. It's pretty cool before I change it. So if you just put a block down here, it's going to activate everything. And it's going to extend this. And I'll show you what happens. So let's get right in the center of this block. This is so frustrating, guys. I really wish that lag wasn't a thing. Look at that. What in the world? Why can't we just get... Guys, I've tried it. I promise you I've tried it. I put glass walls here. And when that happens, you just get glitched inside the block. So it's happening in like a zero tick pulse or something. And it's just like, or like a one tick pulse. And it's just not slow enough. And there's no way with the redstone that I have here for this to do what it's supposed to do, which is raise you up. So instead, every time you do that, you've got to come around here, then jump up onto it. So it kind of makes that completely useless. Because why have that when you could just have a freaking a static block and a stair there at all times anyway? It would do the exact same thing. So what I'm going to do is instead of having it be to where that bud switch activates this double piston extender, I'm going to have this lever activate the double piston extender. So we come in here, we go bam, and this shoots us up in the air. And then when we place down our blocks, I'm going to use this bud switch to turn the clock on and off so we don't have to listen to that horrible sound. Yeah, so that's the plan. So just to explain, you know, what it is we're doing here and what doesn't work about this double piston extender, because the stupid game lag is stupid. So what that means, I get to do one of my favorite things ever, which is rip out redstone with the instant mine. Oh, I love it so much. So let's do that. I'll do it on camera, whatever. I'm having a good day today recording the hangout process. Everyone, you know, I was going to ask you guys about that too. Make sure to let me know what kind of episodes you like more. Do you like the hanging out and doing everything on camera, or do you like lots of progress? Because obviously the downside of the progress episodes is they come out a lot less often. They skip over a lot of really interesting, important stuff as well. I think we need this torch here to be on all the time. Yeah, because this is how this whole thing works. So I'll show you what this is before I rip out too much of it. It's pretty cool. So this is a tree farm circuit, which you see in a lot of tree farms. So we've got a constant power source. Oh, which also I want to switch out too. So I want to make the lever be that constant power source as well to further compactify this. Anyway, so we've got a power source here. And this is really weird. Really, really weird. But because of quasi-connectivity, we're able to power through that block and power down here onto this piston through a bud switch, right? It's super, super technically weird. And then because it's bud switched, it needs an update to be able to make it extend, right? Well, that's where the clock comes in. So you see this clock is going by the piston, but it's not activating the piston directly. So it's just acting as a block update. So while the clock is on, let's turn it on. I'll show you. No, we don't want delay. We want the lever on. Okay. So you see, it's not activating the lever, right? Or the piston, but as soon as we put a block down, that redstone wire that's hanging out next to it is going to update the piston, and it's going to extend. So as soon as a mushroom grows, bam, the thing extends. Super, super cool, super, super handy. Like I said, you use that in a lot of different tree farms. But today, I think I'm going to rewire this around a little bit. I think I already explained it. So let's get on with this. I'll quit rambling. I will BRB. Are you kidding me? Come on. So I've had this debate. I've had this debate with a couple people now about whether quasi-connectivity and translocation should be in the game. I don't think they should be, you guys. I don't think that, I really don't think that this should be in the game, this quasi-connectivity, even though it's used all the time. And it's because it just doesn't make any freaking sense. Like, if you know what you're doing, if you've been redstoning for a really, really long time, God, then you might be able to figure it out and, like, use it to your benefit, and it might make some stuff smaller or whatever. But guys, in general, gosh, it's something like, I'm trying to figure out how to explain this, and I think it comes down to the fact that imagine if you were a brand new redstoner. Imagine if you're trying to learn how to do redstone, and someone is, no, not even, you don't have someone telling you about translocation or quasi-connectivity, because you don't watch videos, you're just playing the game. Imagine how frustrating and stupid and how much it would make you not want to play the game if you kept running into things like that and not understanding why they were happening. Like, so for that reason, I really think that they shouldn't be in the game, that they should fix those things, because then stuff like this would just be, it would just be easy to do. Anybody could do this, but as it stands now, you've got to be a freaking wizard to be able to understand all the little stupid glitches about redstone and then work around them. So for that reason, I think that that it just hinders the game more than it helps the game by compactifying stuff. Let me know what you think, guys, down in the comment section. That would be an interesting topic to debate. Anyway, let's see if that works. We've got our clock. It's going right next to the piston, so hopefully that will update it when we place a block down. So let's do that. Let's put a block down. Oh, yeah. And it turned our clock off? Oh, right. It doesn't make the sound while this is here. Okay, that's cool. Well, maybe we don't even need this little tree detector deal. Yeah, I can't really even see what we're going to use that for, but maybe we'll do like a musical circuit or something like that, like Etho is doing. Anyway, now let's figure out the double piston extendor. This is going to be a little bit difficult because I was just somehow able to make that last one work, and I don't even know how I did it, so let's try it here on camera. Maybe we'll figure it out. Obviously we're going to want to put our pistons down because we know that those are going to have to go there, but as far as how to power them, I'll show you what I came up with. If I can remember, geez, this is difficult kind of. Let's get a floor here. Okay, so how do they do this? It was a block and a torch somewhere. I can't remember where it was. I think it was right there. Let me think about this for a second. Yeah, and then a block there. Yeah, that's how it worked. Cool, and then we need a different floor block there. So you can see obviously what's going on. Torch, piston, block, piston. And then if we were to take the signal away, hold on a second. How's this going to activate? Don't you just freaking love compactifying redstone? I sure do. Trying to fit everything into a little neat little package. Seriously, though, this is like my favorite part about the game. I say that about so many different things. I love Minecraft. Okay. So you can see that if we just turn it off, that piston gets left behind. So we're going to need a way to retract that fully, and then afterwards give it an extra little pulse to grab that block. So let's think about this again. Well, let's compactify this even more. I don't know if that's a good idea to put that there, but I'm going to do it. Ooh, also, do you think that I don't think that's going to activate that piston bud, because it's going to be activating the block in front of the piston, or like, you know, it's going to be updating that block instead of the piston arm or something. Hopefully, I don't think the repeater will do it either. Not that that would even really matter, but let's try something like that, and then maybe we could wrap it back around. It's interesting because we need, I think we need a monostable circuit. I'm pretty sure that's, yeah, I got an extra piston in my inventory because of that. That's how I did it. I had a monostable. I am so brand new at this game. today, apparently. I'm having one of those days where I'm just like, I don't know. I'm just not thinking properly. Let's put this in the right spot. Apparently, I forgot how to make a monostable circuit. Come on, there we go. It's got to be up on that block, which means we could put a block there and put a redstone dust there, and that should work fine. See, I know what I'm doing. I'm figuring it out. I won't let you down. So let's double extend the pistons. And then hopefully when we turn it off, obviously I switched that around, so now it's going to activate that sucker. We got a little bit of delay down there. Okay, which should give us a second pulse to grab that block, I hope. I don't know if that's going to work, though. What? Come on now. Is there a reason? I think I need a repeater there. Oh my gosh. I forgot how redstone works today, somehow. Let's try this again. There we go. Jesus. But then also we've got the... How do we do that? Double extension. Double retraction. Interesting. I don't know how I did that last time. I might have to go back and look at the footage because I am super confused as to how I was able to make this work. Let's try something like just ridiculous here. Maybe that will do it. Yeah? That's such a bad idea. Okay, let's figure this out. So obviously, we got to have that one activate again as well. So this is getting way more big than it was last time, and I don't know why. I don't know how I was able to figure it out last time and not this time. There we go. Man, that is really ridiculous, but it totally works. So you can see what's happening there when it retracts the monostable, pulses that one, which grabs the piston. Then it goes around and pulses the piston, which grabs the block. Pretty cool. I mean, like I said, that is pretty clustery, but it works. So hopefully now, let's see if we've got this correct. Let's turn this off too. Or turn it off, let's get rid of that. So we turn it on, and the clock starts, and we get pushed up into the air. Obviously, because stupid things. Actually, you know what? Let's try this out and see if it's the same, because the last one was because of the timing. Let's see if the timing is different here. Are you kidding me? This is what I'm talking about. Why does that happen? It's so stupid. So we're going to need a stair here. This is why I did this whole thing, by the way. This whole design is because of that stupid lag glitch. Because instead of having to go up and down like that... That's... Okay. So this is default state. Obviously, that would be a mushroom stem. Actually, this would be off. There we go. So this is default state. Mushrooms in place. The thing is down. So if you've got an idea on how to make it to where this can actually push us up like that, let me know. For now, I have had success with jumping. Oh man, but you gotta jump at the perfect time, so it's completely useless, essentially, is what I'm trying to say. Yeah. But anyway, default state. Let's just think about this again. So default state is like that. What we're going to do is we're going to hit the lever. We're going to walk up to it. We're going to break everything. So let's do that. Let's break everything. And just to give you a real-time estimation on how quickly you can build up all of these mushroom blocks with this design, let's do that. Let's do that. And then let's do that. Yeah, that works out pretty well. There you go. And you're instant mining mushroom blocks. And you don't have to come down. I think that was pretty obvious that you didn't have to come down every time because you don't need to collect the mushrooms every single time. Obviously, as well, we could put in some kind of water stream, but because we've got like redstone and stuff here on the ground, I think that would be kind of difficult. I don't think it's really necessary. Like, you know, we could have everything auto-collect, but since this is like a manual farm anyway, it makes sense to just do a couple mushrooms and hop down there and grab all of the fuel and then go throw it in there and then rinse and repeat. So yeah, I'm happy with that. And then we can hit the lever and we'll, you know, de-extend that. Again, totally unnecessary, just for the cool factor. Oh my god, you did what you're supposed to. So anyway, I unfortunately Ran out of time for today's episode. I talked it all away, but I had a really good time hanging out today. I hope you did too. Let me know if you did in the comment section. And maybe give me some love as well. You guys know what to do. You're awesome. Before you go as well, let me just show you a couple little things I did here. Super quick, so I'm thinking you just saw me go from the portal down over to here. We're gonna take a right, and of course there is guys in our way. Look at that. Get out of here. I know the sound from those guys is like cacophony of loudness. I apologize, I need to turn that down. So anyway, we come up right here and we're gonna be, speaking of which, I'm gonna turn it down right now. And there you go. Should be a little better. That was driving me crazy in editing. I hope you guys don't, sorry about that. Anyway, we're gonna come up here right in the middle, on the middle line, which would be cool. Probably go up a little bit too, so we have another cart up there so we can come up at the top layer like that, and then go down in the same way to this layer. Still have yet to do the floor glass stuff. I plan on like walling this all off so it's all the purple glass here, so it's like nice and sealed in. And then obviously clean all of this stuff up because it looks really janky right now. Probably take this box out, hide that redstone a little better. There's a lot of stuff to do. I hate this. Don't look at this. Don't judge it. I hate it. It's really bad. I'll figure out something. Let me know if you guys got any ideas for this tunnel. I've been having a really hard time figuring that out. The block palette here, not so much. I hate the snow. Really don't think the snow fits here in the end project, so let me know. Like I said, if you got any ideas. I think it's a little better over here, but that's because there's like white chorus. I don't know. Anyway, like I said, I had a really good time hanging out today. Let me know if you did too. Let me know if you got any ideas, suggestions about any of the stuff we've been up to here in our world. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a really good day. Bye-bye. And then we've got normal pistons with our cauldron here. And this is a power source that won't bud our pistons if you use a comparator. So that's what that's about. And, you know, the signal just comes up here to the top. It pushes this up. It'll push this into place, and it'll make you stick up here.